Oh, g'day, Joey here. Back to Blues Solos for Acoustic Guitar by Johnny Norris. Today's song is called Barroom Blues, and we're just doing the preparation, as has become my habit going through this book. Only after this one, there's only four songs left, so we're nearing the end, which will be a sad day for me, because I've really enjoyed going through it. So this is preparation for Barroom Blues. Just one thing, it does not involve alternating bass lines, so it's a single bass line, yes, in the key of E, so it's mainly E, A, and then one bar of B. It's got a very nice turnaround and a nice end. So let's just go through the bits and pieces, starting with the very two opening bars. And this is what Johnny Norris does in his book. He dedicates a page to just learn a few bits and pieces before he puts it all together, and so we're doing a similar thing. Learn the various parts in isolation, and then hopefully we can, when the time comes for me to do a complete playthrough, say in 1 or 2 weeks' time, we'll be able to do it in a unified whole. So we start with this high note. We're on the 12th fret, B string. So before we even start playing our bass, so you want to do the hammer on at the start of the very bar for your first bass note, and then there's another hammer on there you would have heard. Yeah, that's that. Then the second bar where we come down to A. You hit that bass note first. I want to put my second finger on that fourth fret, G string. Because I'm going to do a slide for the next bass note. Yeah. Let's put the two bars together. Yeah, that's it. Then there's a couple of bars at E, and then we basically do that same opening riff over the A bass. So it becomes, yeah. So for the practice, I've got you to do a bar of the E bass, and then just to get used to that changeover. Back to the E. Okay, that's those bits. Here, we've got one bar of B, like any 12-bar blues. We're at 12-bar blues, so we've got E, A, two bars of E, two bars of A, two bars of E. Then we have a single bar of B, and it goes like this. So here I am, I'm barring 7th fret. Yeah. You keep doing the bass note. But for practice, I've got you up here on the 5th fret doing that E note. Now, the reason that this is a good thing to practice, if you go straight here, as if nothing else is coming before you, you get the chance to do a nice bar. And that's okay, it's good to practice that. It's even better to practice coming from somewhere else and then try and get that bar happening so that all those notes that you got to play high up ring out nicely. And for me, at the moment, I've got like a 50% success rate, right? Yeah? So there you go. I didn't get that. I didn't get it then. So this is why. Didn't get then either. That was a tiny bit better. you get the point. practice coming from elsewhere on the fretboard, and then trying to get that bar nice, you know, on beat. Yeah, good thing to practice. Really good thing to practice. And then, sorry, I forgot to mention. Go to that A bass. So practice getting that. You go back to the A chord. Practice getting that A bass in there. Straight after that. Now let's go to the turnaround. It's a nice turnaround. It's a bloody hard turnaround. Yeah. Let me do it nice and slow. In fact, I can only do it slow at the moment. So you got low E, high E, and then you're hitting the open E. So that open E string, you're repeating it. And it gives you the opportunity to sort of change position. So that's meant to be the idea. So there you've got a G sharp and D note, yeah, so, which makes an E7. A and C sharp. Now, I'm showing you Johnny Norris's suggested fingering. I'm using the first finger because we're finishing a part where we're at this part of the neck. So you're already got your first finger on that E note, so you sort of got to use it. Slide it down, bring in the G sharp. Now to get to the A and C sharp, he wants you to get your third finger down there. It's a big move, yeah? Very hard to get on time and clean, I've discovered. I'm getting better at it. This is why we do the prep. we do the prep to get ready to play the whole song. Yeah, and then you got this A sharp over C, and then slide up to do the B. Okay, let's do that nice and slow again, and then I'll show you the rest of the turnaround as shown on the screen. And it ends with you having to get back up to that 12th fret. So a really nice turnaround. It'll be fantastic once I can do that nice and smooth. Really nice thing to practice, I think. Yeah. And then you've got to get back into that groove. That I haven't practiced, to go from the turnaround to that nice and smooth. So that's where we have to end up being. That's why we do the prep. Last thing, ending, nice ending. So we're doing the turnaround again. So this will repeat twice. You do that change. We're calling this, by the way, I should have mentioned that bit. See, that's part of a C9. I've called it a C9 on the, but you're only doing the high notes. Then you introduce the D sharp for the B9. So that is a full B9 shape. Yeah. Yeah. All right, so C9 and B9 for that bit of the turnaround, and then for the ending we drop the C9 and B9 and introduce other ninths, which I'll show you right now. We're doing the same bit of the turnaround, so this, that's part of an F9, but we're not doing the F bass or that E bass. Yeah, so once again, the full turnaround. No, I didn't play that too cleanly. That's roughly how it's going. By the way, that ending reminds me a lot, very similar to, similar idea, different chords. You know the ending of Heartbreak Hotel with Elvis, where then they go. Similar thing happening, different, it's still F to E, but different chords. But similar concept. I thought that was better. Yeah, nice end, eh? Really nice end. Actually, nice turnaround all round. That's going to be tough. I'm talking personally, tough to get that nice and smooth, but that's what I'll work towards. I'll do the whole playthrough in 2 weeks' time, I reckon, about 2 weeks' time, and There might be one or two other bars I'll show you that I've skipped now, just because it wasn't part of Johnny Norris's preparation, but which will require a bit of practice. Well, there's one bar that's more difficult than everything we've just done. Okay, Blues Solos for Acoustic Guitar by Johnny Norris. That's Barroom Blues. That's our preparation. I'll do a full playthrough, let's say, in a couple of weeks. Okay, something to practice. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.